Hi, I'm at La Défense. I have some clips up from 2010 of this place. I was taken on a wonderful tour by the guy who designed Le Cœur de la Défense. And that was great, and I have some clips up from 2010 about this place. I used to work here, and I don't come over here very often. This was the Manhattan of Paris, and it's not actually in Paris. It's to the west of Paris. See, there's Cœur de la Défense. And it was thought of in the late 50s and early 60s, and this enormous shell concrete sculpture here, which is called the CNIT, C-N-I-T, went up in the early 60s, and it was for some sort of exposition. And I think it's the only structure of its kind in the world. Pure concrete touches the ground at 3 points. And it's, as you can see, it's covered up and it's undergoing a lot of renovation. And the inside has been renovated. And I have a lot of clips up about that. This place got kind of filled up some time ago. So what's happening is in La Plaine Saint-Denis, which is where I live in Saint-Denis, the new La Défense is going up. So this is already kind of passé, but it's still very vibrant, and I don't really know why, but I've always kind of liked it here. You know, it's like from a Jacques Tati movie or something, and actually Tati did film here when the area was still empty. And this kind of really got going in the 80s. It took a long time to do. And it's very big. There are two metro stops here. That's Paris in the distance. You can't see because it's a bit smoggy or hazy today. This is in the towns of Courbevoie, Neuilly, and Puteaux, if I remember correctly. And there's nothing going on here in the evenings or the weekends, but I don't see the elevators running. You know, they're frequently out of order. And I know people who've worked in this building who said it's very badly designed and not a pleasant place to work. But although it costs a fair amount to get up into the top of the arch, I've done it, and it's really worth it. It's crazy, but it's really worth it. It's a little bit scary going up in the glass elevators, but there's a beautiful space at the top with a nice cafe and at least one restaurant and sanitary facilities and an observation deck and quite a good gift shop. And it's just really worth it. That's about all I can say. Over here is Les Quatre Temps, which is a huge, huge, huge shopping mall. Again, going back to the 80s, it's still pretty popular. It's on many, many, many levels. And if I feel up to it after my business meeting this morning, I might go into it to eat lunch at the casino cafeteria, which is really cool. And I recommend it. It's quite a bargain. There's even a way, if you speak French and have the internet, that you can reserve a table there, which is great for meeting friends. And everybody can just pick the food they want and pay for themselves, and they offer all kinds of foods there. It's a really good deal, you know. And there's also, you can get a little alcohol, you know, wine, soda, beer, cider, little French cocktail sort of thing, if you want it. It was kind of unpleasant riding the train here this morning, and I was glad that I don't have to commute very much anymore. I always tell people, give yourself 2 hours to get from point A to point B in Paris. And I know that sounds excessive, but it's not a bad point of reference, because even though public transportation here is quite good and it's pretty good value for your money, it really can take a long time. and things do go wrong. You know, there are breakdowns and stuff, and things really do get crowded, and connections can take a long time. If you get to a place early, such as what I am doing now, I don't mind being busy, but I really don't like to rush. I woke up at 4 o'clock this morning. I had a nice slow morning getting myself cleaned up and having breakfast and just feeling relaxed. When you get to a place a little bit early, just have one of those little packets of tissues, which you need in a lot of countries. You definitely need in France, because even if you go into quite a nice place and use the bathroom, for which you're usually expected to spend some money, there may very well not be toilet paper. And, you know, dress appropriately and bring something to read and just relax. You know, if you have some money on you, go and get a hot chocolate or something and read a paper. Enjoy yourself. I hope that makes sense. When people come to visit here and I guide them, I tell them to try to get out in the morning and do their sightseeing, and try not to probably plan to see more than one site per day. You know, they'll be kind of lucky if they can squeeze in two. And it could be a bit tiring. You know, with some planning, yeah, you know, you can see a couple things and, you know, but France is not a night country. And things do close up at the end of the afternoon, and they close for lunch and blah, blah, blah. So this is it. This is one end of La Défense. This is the far end. Oh, if you go to this end on the other side of the arch, it's called Le Parvis. And there are some nice places to sit, and you can overlook a big old cemetery. It's kind of cool. I've been in the cemetery. That you kind of need a car to get over there. You can't walk from here, but I've been in it, and I've looked through it with my husband. It's very interesting. All right, see you later. Bye.